myself Nabil Vadeta, and I have my co-speaker Abhishek Anand with me, and we are going to present and our session is with Drupal 8 with Underscore and Backbone.js. Regarding me, I work for Acquia as a senior developer, and apart from the contribution, I'm a Git admin at Drupal.org and maintainer of several modules, and also the co-maintainer of groups.drupal.org. If anyone is interested in maintaining a couple of modules of mine, please feel free to reach me.
Hi guys, I'm Abhishek Anand. I'm a senior technical architect at Acquia, and I'm a maintainer of a couple of modules. I like working with Drupal. At the same time, I'm very fond of JavaScript, and I'm also a front-end guy. Besides Drupal, I like painting. So today's session is about Backbone and Underscore in the code, and we'll briefly look what Backbone is and what Underscore is, how it is being used in code, what is the scope of Backbone and Underscore in Drupal code. At the same time, we will look at a demo where we will have a simple application which we will build using RESTful APIs of Drupal 8 and a one-page application of Backbone. As you know, with Drupal 8, there are a lot of client-side JavaScript libraries which are being experimented, and Backbone got an early adoption in Drupal code. So Naveen will take you through what Backbone is and the further slides.
So with the headless Drupal, we have already know that we do the fetching of the data from some server or some third-party service. That we have some agent request with the jQuery library. Everyone of us have already used it. So we don't have any consistent API or something like that to do that for us. So Backbone is like that. It is providing that functionality out of the box for us. So it gives us a structure to provide some key value binding with the elements that we want to bind some functions or something else with the elements over the web page also. So it gives a it comes up with it has dependencies on underscore.js, so it comes up with lots of handy useful functions like stringify and JSON and so on. So Backbone, we already Backbone follows the MVP model view presenter, but we are not considering MVP presenter here. So there are several ways to present something. The data. So we are only we are only talking about the models and views here. So models are the models just like in the class. Like we are considering. I am assuming that we all already are knows about the Drupal modules and so here. Just like in the modules, we brought up the core PHP code to do something. So but this is. It's a definition of from the Backbone.js. So my definition is that the Backbone model is like a Drupal module, and Backbone view is like a Drupal theme. So whatever I have to do in the CSS also or styling and stuff like that, I'll take care of that in the view. And but if I need to take care of logics and validations and all other stuff, I'll take care of that in models.
So the interaction part with the backend happens with the help of model. What it does is it takes a RESTful object and it prepares it for the view to be used. The view is pretty much what does the DOM manipulation and whatever it changes that it needs to bring in the state of the DOM is carried by the view. This is a simple example of model view interaction that it happens.
So here, if a user will interact with element on the web page, so if we have binded some event like on, off, on focus, out focus, we have binded that event with view with that in the models. If that user will interact with that particular element on the web page, then an event will fire, then view will send a response to the model that this now this event has to be happened. Now the logics or logics or validation or access controls or anything else that we have written on our model part, our business logic, that will get executed and it will return out the response to us. It depends on our API, whatever we are returning, either XML or JSON.
So let's take a small example. We see a block and there's an edit link on the block. In Drupal 8, when you edit that, it happens with the help of Backbone. Whenever there's an interaction with the user, and when you try to edit the block, there's an inline edit function. It changes the state of the view. Now, model will take that change state and sync that with the database. And the database will return back with some update in the view. The model will again pass that to the view, and view will make appropriate changes to the DOM. So this diagram explains. So we generally have model and view. We do not have any controller which is being used in Drupal core in Backbone.
So underscore is a helper library that Backbone is using. So it comes up with several functions that for setting up, for getting settings, and for manipulating up of data. It has very handful functions like get, set, stringify, JSON, and to approach, and so on. So Backbone is depending on this library. So it's like a hyper library for you. So these are the libraries that are in Drupal core that we have.
Backbone underscore are just like any other libraries. Like you include any other library in Drupal, you include Backbone and underscore in Drupal core. The scope is pretty much limited to the admin section in Drupal core for Backbone and underscore.
So,
taking an example of the event that I was talking earlier, you can see a red round.
So, do you know the guys, the red circle on? Do you guys know this point that where the red circle is? What are these pencil links, these pencil icons?
What does it do?
Yep. These pencil icons are conceptual links. So it's a great example in Drupal core that one of the nice implementation in Drupal core is in the contextual links, where the models, views and controls have been separated out, and it's one of the complex example in core where where the collection of models is also has been taken care of. So Backbone is using in Drupal core in several modules. CK Editor toolbar plugin. Toolbar is for the configuration of the toolbar. We are using the Backbone. And for the conceptual links, and for the quick edit, and toolbar, and two. And there is also planning to replace out the whole field API with the Backbone, because to make it happen on the single page, for at right time, we have to go on several screens to create a single field. So to make it more robust and user-friendly, so there is a discussion going on. So we are still working on a prototype for that. We are not sure how that field API UI diagram, field admin screen, how it will looks like. So now Abhishek will go through with the demo that he has. And later we will show that.
So basically what Naveen was talking about, the implementation of Backbone and underscore in the code. And what we saw is different places where Backbone is being used. CK Editor and contextual links are a very good example. We will look at, refer to these examples later. What I am going to cover is another part where we take a headless Drupal and we expose RESTful APIs for a Backbone app to use it. With this approach, you can totally eliminate all the UI which Drupal provides. Obviously, it comes with a lot of work that you need to do on the front end, but sometimes you might want to do that. It is very handy. Suppose if you are building a mobile application or an application where you do not need the Drupal look and feel at all. You want to build a one-page application and you just want Drupal to be a data store for you and an API for you. Why do we want to use this? Because we want to use Drupal as one platform, and nowadays it's not just about web, we also want mobile apps, and there are several other touch points for our web application. So it's a good idea to have a headless Drupal which exposes REST data in the REST format, and it is being consumed by a backbone application. And we have a one-page application which is very light. So I'll configure a couple of views. We'll take a simple example of article and configure a couple of views to expose RESTful API, and then we will see how Backbone is using it, and we'll look into the detail of the code, the Backbone code that we need to write for that. I'm switching over to PHP Strong, or rather I would switch to So this is vanilla Drupal installation. I have generated some content using devel generate. So we have a content type called article, and we have some content already created. I just used devel generate to create some content. Now, there are a couple of modules that we need to do this. There's a module called services. So RESTful Web Services is the module that we need to use to be able to expose our data in REST format. Now, we'll look at how we can do this using views. So I'm going to create a simple view. Because I've already created one, so I'll just name it article 1, which will show me content of type article. I can create a page for this, but what I'm interested in is providing a REST export for this. And I have to provide a path which will be used as an endpoint for the application. So the path would be articles, and I'll just keep it REST so that I can leave the article part for the normal HTML page. Once I create this, I have got a display called REST export. What this is going to do is it's going to send the data in REST format, it's JSON, and I'll use this in our Backbone app. I might not want to show the whole entity because it comes with a lot of fields, links and stuff like that. So I'll just switch it over to things. I'll just add body field. Now what I get is a title and a body field in a JSON format. So now my endpoint from Drupal side is ready. If I visit this URL, I'll get my data. So this is the data that I'm getting from Drupal. You can use views extensively to do this. This is the best way in which you can expose your data for consumption by a Backbone app. You can do this for, you can use views for pretty much anything. If you want to expose a single article, like if you want to have something like node/nid, you can have article slash article ID. You can create a view with a simple app with a contextual filter, which will take your node ID and it will generate just one node. Now, this endpoint can be used in an Angular app. So in my, so I have created a root folder because I want to use the same domain. In the root folder, I have, there are only two files which are of my use, which is index.html and there's an app.js. In my index.html, I have just added some libraries, underscore and backbone and jQuery, and I'm writing some code. I'll simplify this to you later. I'll just show a demo and I'll do it. And there's an app.js file, which has a simple model, there's a view, and there's a collection, which we'll look at in detail later on. I need to specify my endpoint here, which is already there. So now I need to visit this URL, index.html, and I will, I'll see what we get there. So now this is a totally different look and feel, which lists down all my articles, which is fetched from Google. To get into details of how we did this, the HTML file has some existing divs which will be used by Backbone to add these things. So first thing we need to do is we need to add required libraries, and everything else is just styling thing. There are two major templates. We'll look at what template is. This is a template, article view, and this is an article list. Article view is like, you can say HTML in Drupal, and article list is like node teaser. So article view is providing template for the whole list of articles, and article list is providing the template for just one article. So these two are, these two templates are required. And then we specify a div where Backbone has to add its data. So that div can be found somewhere. Div ID main content. So Backbone will add the data here. Let's look at our Backbone app. There's nothing that we need to do in the model because we are not doing anything. We are just getting the data and passing it to the view. We need to have a collection which will fetch the data from the URL. And the major thing which is happening is in the view. The view is getting the element as main content. It is fetching the template from the article list. And then it's initializing this. And this part is the render part, which is generating the ULLI from the data, the list from the data, which is in the template, and it is giving it to the article view model. There's an article model view, and there's an article view view. So we have article list view, which will generate the master list, and then for each individual list, it will keep adding it to the article view list in the model, and we are passing the model here. So this is being rendered. This goes to article view, and article view renders it in an LI. Okay, sure. Good enough? Yeah. So should I repeat what I said? So basically what I said was we are not doing too much with model. We have a collection and then there's view. There's no data manipulation that we are doing in the model, so we are not changing the model at all. We are just getting the data, and there are two views that we have written. One is for the list and for each list item.
which is called article view and article list. Article list is getting the element for main container where it will append its data. It is getting the article list as a template, which we saw right now in index.html, and then it starts rendering the article view, which is a single article, and it passes the model to it, and we have article view, which renders each li as per a template of article. Now you can extend this. You can extend this to individual pages as well without going to a different page. I have done that as well, which I will show you. How do I exit presentation mode? So this was a simple one-page app which is just consuming data from Drupal and it is rendering it. If you want to make it more fancy, what you can do is you can have your route. So this is another example of wine. I had a wine content type. This is not functional. I was doing it, but there are still bugs to solve in this, so I can't show you a demo of this. But what we are doing here is we are defining routes. Two different routes. So the second route is the ID, which is passed as a parameter to wine details, and it renders the view according to the ID which is passed. It will fetch the ID with this URL, so my endpoint will be Drupal8/wine/ID. So again, I have written another view which will expose data in the REST format to this ID. That will be a single node data using conceptual filters, and it will get the data and it will render it. So now we have just a one-page app which has a list and there are IDs. Once I click the ID, it will append the view to have the node of that particular ID. It will make a callback to Drupal, fetch the data, and it will append it to the existing view. So there is no page node or anything. It's just a backend call to the service call to Drupal, which returns a REST. Which returns a JSON format and which is consumed by this app. So this was the demo which I wanted to show you. The other thing is, what is the future of backbone in Drupal core? Why was it adopted and is it really gonna go any further? There are certain drawbacks with backbone. Backbone has no built-in data binding, which means any logic to change the view or make any wrong manipulation has to be written in your backbone through your custom code. There's no built-in data binding which will update the view automatically from your JSON file or from the model. So this has to be manually written in backbone. This is a drawback because there are other JavaScript libraries like Angular which does it for you. And it relies on getters and setters, which is again not an ideal thing to do. And backbone also does not have any stuff like virtual DOM. So any manipulation it does on the actual DOM, and once the DOM is updated, it is very hard to get back to the original state. So any changes reflect directly to the DOM, and we do not want to do that because now we have an advanced system where you create a virtual DOM, and any changes you make to the virtual DOM and the real DOM stays as it is. But backbone will modify the DOM, and you cannot change the state back to the original one. So these are the major drawbacks of backbone. So in future, most likely backbone is going to be confined to the admin experience, where you have the inline, the views UI or the fields UI, all these things. Whatever I showed you about the inline editing will probably be changed. The key Drupal community is trying to figure out ways or trying to find out a unified solution where they have a better library, and they're looking at Angular, JS, Ember, and or ELM libraries. Angular is supposedly more advanced than backbone. Why backbone was selected was it is the oldest one and it has a high adoption in open source community. That's why it was included in Drupal 8. But as far as going further is concerned, backbone will not be the primary library, JavaScript library which will be used with Drupal. Most probably with the further versions of Drupal, or maybe in Drupal itself, we will see something like Angular or Ember, which will be adopted more more than backbone underscore. And there's this issue queue, which has which is having discussion going on. If you have any ideas around this, you can always contribute to this issue queue. This is the last session of the day. We will not take much of your time. We can open the rest of the time for any Q&A that you might have. This is pretty much what we had for our session. Any questions?
GraphQL and they are comparing out the AngularJS, Angular 2 and GraphQL for the client side framework. So backbone was, because they are still, this meta is issues for the backbone, for the admin UIs, for the backend, not from the front end. So probably there is open issue going on for that discussion as well. This is the different
point. Backbone is only going to stay in the admin UI, it's not going to come out admin UI. For all user-related stuff, all stuff that user sees, non-admin user sees, there's still a discussion, and Angular and Ember are the biggest contender for this. Angular has lately has picked up more than backbone, so that is the biggest contender. But Angular has its own discussion. And if you disable JavaScript, your application becomes supported and usable in Angular. You see a lot of tags and stuff like that. You can't use the backbone. Advantage with backbone is it can, you do not need to do all those stuff with backbone. You can just use it as a component for certain things. So this was added for developers for giving them a choice if they want to use Angular as a library. Any module can define Angular as a library, or if they do not want to, they can totally change it, add a new library and replace this and use that. That's the reason why underscore and backbone was adopted. And it is very lean and thin. It's a very thin library, so and you do not want to make Drupal very front-end heavy as well. That's the reason why it was with Angular, there are also problems which we can discuss. That's the reason why. Backend server side. As far as I knew what React is, I have limited knowledge of React. It was Meteor. Meteor is the one which runs with Node.js. Meteor.js, React. I don't have too much of knowledge about React, but I don't think there's any adoption for any server-side JavaScript running for Drupal as of now, because it will be solving the same problem which Drupal is solving. You can use Drupal in conjunction with Node.js. Like Drupal is not very good when it comes to real-time interaction. So when you have something which is meant for very high I/O, for example, if you have a Facebook-style notification, or if you want to have a real-time chat, These are the problems which are not being solved by Drupal right now. The Drupal is still relying on long polling or Ajax polling methods, unless they use Node.js module. So these are the problems that you can solve with that, but other than that, anything that you do with server-side JavaScript would primarily be doing the same thing which Drupal is doing. So I don't think, or I'm not aware of any such conversation which is happening around it. For a specific role.
Suppose I ideally would show the whole content type of a specific ID. But if I have a management role, and he or she doesn't need to know because he doesn't need to show the administrative content, then what would be the pass? What would be the end point? Is there two parameters as a context?
Yes, I think you have to pass, because whatever interaction that is happening between your backbone app and your Drupal app is through the GET request that you are passing. Yes. So generally what happens is you might not use underscore this for admin users. You still have your admin interface. So you'll have to pass that as a parameter.
I can.
Yes. You have to add another parameter. Yeah, but your application needs to, your front-end application needs to know, right? Your Drupal will know that I have to render this view for this role. But how would your when your application, your front-end application is requesting a URL, at the end it is just requesting a URL to the view.
Same URL can return a different content for a different role type.
Yes, but then how would you pass the session and this stuff? Yeah, but you are just sending a request. You need to pass a token through the URL, like session was handled earlier. Or make a post request and pass it in the post session. Right? Even that can happen. Either do a GET or a POST. That's the reason why backbone is for the admin section. And for any module that you are using, like I said, for any module that you are using, you replace these libraries and you can use that as a library. Drupal will just support, the core will just support the use of this library. You can use this library. It might not necessarily get into the core. It will just support these libraries. You can use this library. Yes. For example, there are a lot of modules which has mixed licensing. That's why we have libraries module. Your module which is GPL licensed does not need to have a third party library which might have some other license. That brings in the licensing issue. So yeah, of course, unless it is GPL, it will never get into Drupal core because we cannot get into mixed licensing. That's why there are several other libraries which are being. The idea is to get unify and have a platform where you can use a lot more front end libraries than just underscore and platforms.
Thank you.
C2 is using its own custom library for doing that. So C-tools has to be compatible with that one. That one doesn't have to be compatible with C-tools. So I'll have to check in the code whether C-tools is using that one, but I have not.
In the hotel?
Right. You're saying that C2s should support. If C2s is not using that, then it's a nice feature that we can file an issue for that. Why do you go ahead and file an issue for C2s? I don't think C2s is using underscore or that one. But yeah. But if you have a recommendation, you can always do a feature request in the issue queue and the maintainers will look at it. Thank you. Thank you guys.
Thank you.